Farm. My name's Roz, also known as Passion Flower, and you'll find me here each week talking about my farming and creative life. We've finally had some consistent rain. Rain that is actually going... Wade's gone super crazy right now. Oh, I'll have to show you what he was doing. We've got rain that's actually filling the tanks and filling the dams and is creating real puddles. Earlier in the year I was talking about having to pump water to our main house tank because we were running out of water and at the point where we almost had to buy some. But now we're actually pumping water back from our main house tank to our spare concrete tank because it doesn't have a roof or anything to get any runoff, so we actually need to make sure that we fill that early in the season before we fill our house tank. The house tank should actually be full after today, I think. We've had consistent rain all day today and we had about 90 mil of rain yesterday, and tomorrow it's also expected to rain for a large part of the day as well. So we are going to be at the point where we have full tanks, which is quite exciting. And now we just need additional rain to fill up the dams. This week, the majority of the cows have been moved on either to market or to different paddocks away from our farm. Our paddocks had begun to run out of feed. We were starting to obviously get more water, which was good, but the grass was not growing enough while the cattle were grazing on it. So we've moved them along for a little while. We have about, I think, 10 or so still here. And that should be okay across the two large paddocks that we have. But what we need to do now is to harrow the paddocks, which means to spread the manure across all the paddocks and also try to improve some pastures potentially with throwing out some seed or some kind of treatment. We haven't decided what we're going to do yet, and we'll be working in conjunction with the farmer who has been leasing the land, whose cows they are, to make sure that we get the best results for the paddocks moving forward. I found a few interesting things on my walks this week. It's nice that every time I leave the house and I go for a walk in the paddocks or out in the bush, I notice something new or I see something different or there's something that I haven't noticed before. This week I saw a snake skin in the paddock. Not a snake, just its skin, which was pretty cool. I also saw a possum sleeping up in a tree quite out in the open. I'm wondering if perhaps it got chased up there by a feral cat or a fox or something during the night and it got to a point where it was stuck and couldn't get back to its normal sleeping place for the night. And then I also found a cocoon. It was quite a large cocoon, so I'm assuming that it was quite a large moth or butterfly that came out of it, but I haven't been able to figure out what it is yet. I've been looking in some Google images trying to figure it out, but I don't know what it is. People know me for me wearing hand knits, and the other day I was out and I was wearing this, which is Nuvum by Martina Bem, which I knit back in 2013. And it's in a 2-ply silk and merino blend that I got from Wangaratta Woolen Mills. Knit on very small needles to make a very fine fabric. And when I said, oh, no, I am wearing hand knit, no, this is the hand knit item. I made this, and they were in awe and shock, and but in a good way. It was, I think people often think that things that are handmade or hand knit seem to somehow have to look homely, or you know, that sort of homemade, not done in a professional, crafty kind of way. And this is something that I think you absolutely could see hanging up in a shop and that you would think to purchase, opposed to perhaps some of my other knits that are quite unique in terms of, you know, bright colours or colours that may not necessarily be put together, or very unique hand dyed yarns.
Whereas this being a full black piece and on such small needles, it does look like perhaps it was done by a machine. And I wasn't offended that they thought that it was done by a machine. I was quite flattered that my knitting was so good that they actually couldn't tell that I had made it. I do think that some people think that anything that is handmade or hand knit somehow has to be a bit kitschy or not stylish or fashionable, or that you can see faults or that it's not going to be properly finished, that it might be a little bit amateurish. And I think that as a knitter, I am a hand maker and I have skill, and that it's a craft that I have perfected over a number of years. I would proudly say that it's handmade, and that it is of a standard that can be mistaken for coming from a shop. Well, that's it for another week. Thanks for spending some time with me. If you enjoyed this episode, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And I look forward to seeing you next week on the farm. Bye.